You're watching TVC News. The Nigeria Diaspora Commission was established to protect Nigerians in diaspora and to facilitate their effective participation in Nigeria's development. There are about 17 million Nigerian diasporans, if others with Nigerian origin are added. The figure could be as high as 40 million. It is indeed pertinent to ensure this set of Nigerians are not neglected. Moyo Thomas met with the chairman and CEO of the commission and files in this report.
Issues continue to revolve around Nigerians in diaspora, many of which tend to be negative, affecting the image of Nigeria and her citizens. Many Nigerians tend to get defined by these prejudices and stereotypes even while contributing meaningfully to their host countries and countries of origin. The need to give these diasporans a voice is why the federal government created the Nigeria Diaspora Commission. It is headed by Abike Dabiri Erewa.
One area that we haven't paid enough attention to. We keep saying, no, we have the best this, the best that, the best that, the best doctors, professors. How do we enhance this enormous human potentials that we have as a nation scattered all over the world? So we create policies to make this happen. We have a diaspora policy that will come on board to get diaspora engagements. This week alone, I can count 20 Nigerians that have excelled. That made news in different parts of the world.
The commission is expected to focus on Nigerian heroes abroad and play a mediation role in turning issues Nigerians get drawn into, either by their own making or through circumstances beyond their control.
Of course, you have the downside. Those that are getting into trouble, you know, in jail or for one thing or the other, where we can intervene. Like there are minor cases where we can intervene, we will work with our embassies. But if you commit a crime, you have to pay for your crime. There are some Nigerians that are in jail because they overstayed their visas. There are some that just cannot pay their bill. For those minor offenses, it's important for our country to see how we can work with those people and get them out. And it's not too difficult to do.
A case in point is that of a 73-year-old Nigerian nanny sentenced to 15 years imprisonment on a murder charge for force-feeding a baby to death.
The Nigerian embassy in Washington, along with Nigerian diaspora organization, they're already working with her. The case is on appeal and trying to see how you can put before the judge the fact that this is a cultural thing. She didn't mean to kill the child, you know. And maybe the 15-year imprisonment can be turned to maybe a manslaughter, lesser years.
It is not all tales of war about Nigerians in diaspora. There are several Nigerians who have distinguished themselves as A-list actors and musicians. Artists with Nigerian origin in Hollywood include Rotimi Akinosho, David Oyelowo, Uzo Aduba, Hakim K. Kazim, Chiwetel Ejiofor, John Boyega, Adewale Akinoye Agbaje, and several others.
What can I say? It's a defense mechanism concealing the deep-rooted insecurity.
I'm talking Kenya. He wants to get back in the game, shut it down, simple as that.
Thousands of medical doctors and surgeons are also practicing in the United States, with about 5,000 in the UK alone. These Nigerian abroad contribute socially and economically to the country's image and development. These Nigerians also fall within categories the new Diaspora Commission hopes to reach out to, and through constant interaction, reinforce their pride in coming from a country still regarded globally as a giant of Africa. It is important to continue to reiterate that every Nigerian is an ambassador, whether in or out of the country, and the action of one impacts all others and the country's image. Moyo Thomas, TVC News, Abuja.